Joys. You heard the word joys and nothing else. One of the great joys of being in a school such as ours is the close proximity to many great colleagues. And you just heard a wonderful piece by a wonderful colleague, Dr. Peter Loughlinger. Our adjunct faculty are first rate, and we are so pleased when we can play pieces and use the talents of our composers and performers that we have on our faculty. So please, another hand for Dr. Peter Loughlinger. It's not for nothing that this piece is based on Walt Whitman's poetry, for Walt Whitman is very important to the founding of our university. 50 years ago, the thing that we've been celebrating with lots of events this last few days. And it's been a great pleasure for us to kind of close out the weekend with this concert of American music. We've had for a long time the Walt Whitman Room in the English department, which apparently just was changed to the Bill Holm and Phil Dacey Room. Both poets and writers, very important to our life here at Southwest Minnesota State and our life here on the prairie. Bill Holm was one of my dearest friends, and I miss him every day. Think about him often, my forehand partner, and as we used to call ourselves, big guys with grand pianos. That was our, we were a big hit on the hot dish circuit. We had what I call impressive reach. We were well known in Lyon and Northern Lincoln counties, just in Northern part. But Phil Dacey, of course, also one of our great poets and one of my absolute favorite poets of all time. And a little bit later, you're going to hear "Ear Abounding," based on Phil Dacey's poetry and put to music by our young, sprightly Dr. Robert Buckner Whitcomb, who's hearing this music now into his 96th year. And it was a piece he wrote that I talked him into, and we premiered it, some 14 years ago. And we've played it several times since, and we thought that was also an appropriate thing to do for this august occasion. This concert also features the chorale. You heard them sing just beautifully just now. We're so lucky to have such fine singers to come to our school. And it will also feature all three of the full-time music professors, myself, Dr. Ginocchio, who will accompany me in the Gershwin, and Dr. Kingsbury, who will lead your accompaniment. But first, we thought we should do a little snippet, a little blast from the past. As you see, Hit Parade from 1967, but Anna and I have decided to call it Seven Hits from 67. The founding of this university. Anna DeGraff has been a joy to work with, and we are so lucky to have her on our faculty. And we put this together, we thought, you know, I'm not a rocker, as you probably have figured out, so I'm doing my best to kind of swing and not be so rigid from the hips down. But she will carry this, I'm sure, beautifully. Please help me welcome to the stage Dr. Anna DeGraff.
windy has stormy eyes, I flash at the sound of lies. And windy has wings to fly above the clouds, above the clouds. Oh, rooting down the streets to the ceiling, smiling at everybody. She sees heroes reaching out to capture a moment. Everyone knows it's windy. Coming to you on a dusty road, girl, I've got a truckload. And when you get it, you got something. So don't worry, 'cause I'm coming. I'm a strong man. I'm a strong man. I'm a strong man. Hey, I'm a strong man. Thank you.
a 60s cocktail dress there for you. Totally vintage. Of course, our own former dean, Jen Loft, had an 80s dress for the prom. I don't know how many people you saw that. It was a little moment of Jesus, as Bill Holmes used to say. It was fantastic. As I said before, we're going to be looking at all sorts of American music in this concert. And the next piece is written by one of my dearest friends, Dr. Robert Whitcomb, who taught for many years at South Coast State. And after that, beautiful setting of Phil Basie's poetry and the combined forces of Southwest Minnesota Orchestra and the SMSU chorale led by Dr. Kingsbury, we're going to do Gershwin Rhapsody in Blue, East Side. Always wanted to play, and I thought, heck, you know, this might be just the thing I need to do for this concert. Of course, many of you know it, have heard it, it's part of the American ear, and we're playing not the absolute original version, but the original version written for orchestra. And I'll be joined by my colleague, Dr. John Ginocchio, who's director of bands and instrumental music here at South Coast State. After the intermission, which I think will be cookies and water back in the lobby, and a good time to get out there, fill out your membership for the orchestra if you haven't done so. Just a little hint there. After the intermission, we're coming back to do the Old American Songs by Aaron Copland, one of the probably the most iconic of all American composers, with our special guests all the way from the United Kingdom, Ryan Hugh Ross and Sean Cameron. And they'll be splitting out those songs up. Ryan, of course, has had a very busy schedule, being the graduate of the last decade of the Gold Alum Award. He got the beautiful alum lunch we had on Friday at noon, and he's been doing lots of things, including an absolute rip-roaring rendition of the Stars and Stripes, our national anthem, yesterday at the football game. And then we'll conclude with some remarks by President Johnny Doors and the John Williams piece. I'll say a little bit more about that later, but you can see everyone's assembled. Please help me welcome to the stage my dear colleague and the conductor of the SMSU Chorale, Dr. Stephen Kingsbury. Thank you. Baco just said to me, "You're talking again?" My supportive concertmaster. Just a few words before I bring out our next. I hate that song. Our next. For our next piece, I wanted to make sure that you. This is awfully high, Mike. It's a high mic. Can you take it? That's just high mic. Well, his name's Mike. So. I wanted to make sure that you knew that I did not have, I did not forget socks. I bought these at the football game yesterday. Oh, I just feel the envy coming out of the audience. It's incredible. It's incredible. Yeah, it's been a big weekend. I went to the football game, got to sit in the swanky university suite, and only because Ryan was around. They never let the likes of me in there, usually. And it was a lot of fun. Kind of a close game right there. Dr. Gores told me that Sioux Falls is ranked 7th in the nation, so we had them on a run for a while. These next pieces are delightful, and they are part of that Americana sound that Aaron Copland was so instrumental in kind of creating kind of our own American euphony. And they're good old plain American English, so you don't need words, you understand it perfectly. Both Ryan and Sean have become, Sean has become a very close friend through her association with Ryan now. And Ryan goes back to when he was just a little kid. He was just a kid at 17 years old, scared. And he gave a very loving tribute to how Southwest Minnesota State changed his life and how it helped him get where he is now today. He has become like a son to me, and I can't tell you how much his artistry and his friendship mean to me. So instead of getting verklempt and crying in front of all of you, I'll just ask you to help me invite to the stage Ryan D. Ross and Sean Cameron.
ask him for your power, but look out, boys, he's a dodging for a note. Yes, we're all dodging.
Yeah.
taxes feel life. I bought me a duck, my duck please me. I fed my duck on the under tree. My duck says quack, quack. My cat says feel life. I bought me a goose, my goose please me. I fed my goose on the under tree. My duck says quack, quack. My duck says quack, quack. Cat says fiddle life. I bought me a hen, my hen please me. I fed my hen on the yonder tree. My hen says shimmy shack, shimmy shack. My goose says quack, quack. My duck says quack, quack. My cat says fiddle life. I bought me a pig, my pig please me. I fed my pig on the yonder tree. My pig says grippy, grippy. My hen says shimmy shack, shimmy shack. My goose says quack, quack. My duck says quack, quack. My cat says fiddle-life. I bought me a cow, my cow please me. I fed my cow on the yonder tree. My cow says moo, moo. My pig says grippy, grippy. My hen says shimmy shack, shimmy shack. My goose says quack, quack. My duck says quack, quack. My cat says fiddle-life. I bought me a horse, my horse please me. I fed my horse on the yonder tree. My horse said neigh, neigh. My cow said moo, moo. My pig says grippy, grippy. My hen says shimmy shack, shimmy shack. My goose says quack, quack. My duck says quack, quack. My cat says fiddle-life. I bought me a wife, my wife please me. I fed my wife on the yonder tree. My wife says honey. My horse said neigh, neigh. My cow said moo, moo. My pig says creepy, creepy. My hen said shimmy shack, shimmy shack. My goose says quack, quack. My duck says quack, quack. My cat says fiddle-life.
Oh,
Ching-a-ring-a-ring, ching-ching. Oh, ding-a-ding, boom-a-larky. Ching-a-ring-a-ring, ching-ching. Oh, a ding, boom-a-larky. Brothers, gather round. Listen to the story about the promised land and the promised glory. Do not need to fear if you have no money. You don't need none there to buy your milk and honey. There you'll ride in style, fortune with four white horses. There the evening meal has 1, 2, 3, 4 courses. Ring-ching-ching, oh, ding-a-ding, boom-a-larky. Ching-a-ring-a-ring-ching, oh, ding, boom-a-larky. Nights will all be dance to the harp and fiddle, thoughts and dreams and plans, and start on the riddle. When the moon comes, the candles stand out in the sun, and there's a holy heart. Brothers, hear me out. Promised lands are coming. Dance and sing and shout, and hear the harps are strumming. Ching-a-ring-a-ring, ching-ching-a-ring-a-ching, ching-a-ching, 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 ching-a-ring-a-ching, ching, ching-a-ring-a-ching, ching, ching-a-ring-a, ching-a-ring-a, ching-a-ring-a-ring, ching, ching, ching.
Thank you.
President Connie Gores of our finest division. Can you just say a few words of what this all means, and wasn't that warming your prairie heart?
Oh, warming my prairie heart and making my eyes water, so I had to scoot off in the distance and take care of my emotion. Well, this was just incredible. Let's thank them one more time. Ryan and Sean. When we opened our doors 50 years ago, this week actually, or this month, I'm not so sure our founders would have ever dreamed that we would have the world-class talent right here in Marshall, Minnesota, on the prairie. And I'm so pleased that Ryan and Sean are here, and that we have this remarkable orchestra here in Southwest Minnesota, and the chorale, and our faculty members, conductors, and all this talent. And so I just want to thank them and thank all of you for everything you've done to make this university the special place that it is. And it wouldn't go without saying to say that all of you in the audience make us who we are as well. So I want to thank you for your support, and thank you for supporting the orchestra in particular. On the back inside cover of our program today is a list of the music calendar for the academic year 2017-18. Please take this home with you and mark these events on your calendar, because we have only just begun to celebrate our 50th year. So thank you for being here, and thank you both for being here, and all the musicians with your talent and your skill.
Thank you, Dr. Gores. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for being here. Well, we're going to finish our program very quickly with a potpourri of movie music that you all know and love, and it's kind of high caffeine, and then we're out of here. Thanks so much for being here. Here's the medley on the themes of John Williams.